गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट, दिस सेशन फॉर क्लास 11 फिजिक्स चैप्टर 3 मोशन इन स्ट्रेट लाइन। ओके स्टूडेंट, टुडे आवर टॉपिक इज यूनिफॉर्म मोशन एंड नॉन यूनिफॉर्म मोशन एंड वी विल स्टडी द कॉन्सेप्ट ऑफ एक्सेलरेशन। ओके सो लेट्स स्टार्ट विथ यूनिफॉर्म मोशन। स्टूडेंट, दिस इज आवर टॉपिक यूनिफॉर्म मोशन। सो आई होप यू नो definition of uniform motion. If object cover equal distance in equal interval of time, in this diagram you can see this is the graph between displacement, which is on y axis, and time on x axis. So in this graph you can see object covers equal distances in equal interval of time. Okay, so if any object covers equal distances, this is distance in this much time. Similarly, this one is distance in this much time. So suppose I can write here 5, 10, 15, and you can write here 2, 4, 6, like, okay. So if object covers 5 meter in each 2 second, then the motion is straight line and the graph will be a straight line, and this motion is known as uniform motion. Okay, motion is known as uniform motion. I hope you understand. So you can write here, if object covers equal distances or displacement in equal interval of time, then motion is known as uniform . Okay now then how we will get velocity of the body in uniform motion? So we know that velocity is equal to displacement upon time. Okay, velocity is equal to displacement upon time. So if you can see, it takes 2 seconds to travel 5 meters. Okay, so you can write 5/2, that is 2.5 meters per second, as meter per second is unit of velocity. Okay, so how we will get displacement upon time. Okay, but in this graph you can see, if we take this angle theta and this one as a triangle OAB, so you can see this one is right angle triangle. Okay, so you can take in right angle triangle ABC, tan theta is equal to AB upon OA, and AB is equal to what? That is 5/2, and it is 2.5 meters per second. It means if a graph is given, if this type of graph is given and you want to find the velocity, you should try to find out this slope. This slope will be equal to the velocity. So you can write V is equal to tan theta. Okay, it means slope of displacement time graph in uniform motion gives velocity. Okay, so this is very interesting result. सो स्लोप ऑफ डिस्प्लेसमेंट टाइम ग्राफ इन यूनिफॉर्म मोशन गिव्स वैल्यू ऑफ वेलोसिटी. ओके सो दिस वन इज डिस्प्लेसमेंट टाइम ग्राफ फॉर यूनिफॉर्म मोशन. ओके नाउ लेट्स चेक velocity time graph. So in this diagram, in this diagram you can see velocity time graph for uniform motion. Students, since you know in this you can see the velocity throughout the motion remains unchanged, it is constant throughout the motion. Okay, it means at different time it should be equal. So in this diagram, suppose this point is 2.5 meter per second. So at 2 second it will be same, it must be same at 4 second, it must be at 6 second, it must be at 8 second. It means velocity at different times will be same. So the motion is known as uniform motion. It means velocity is constant. Okay, so in this motion you can see velocity is constant throughout the motion. So this one is again velocity time graph for uniform motion. So point velocity, you can write velocity is equal to constant in uniform motion. So this one is very interesting result from this graph. Okay, from this graph you can see if for uniform motion velocity time graph is parallel to the time axis. Okay, so it means here if velocity is v1 and here if velocity is v2, then this v1 must be equal to v2. Okay, so I hope you are getting my point. These are very interesting results, we will discuss it later. Okay, so remember v1 is equal to vt in uniform motion and this one is velocity time graph. Okay, so now we are going to study what is non-uniform motion. Okay, so you can see here a graph between displacement and time. Along x-axis we have time and along y we have displacement s. Okay, so you can see, suppose this much distance is covered by object in some second. Suppose this one is 1. Now the distance is very less in second, 1 second. This one is again 1 second. So you can see this distance is greater than this one. Okay, so this motion is non-uniform. So if object does not cover equal displacements in equal intervals of time, then motion is non-uniform. I hope you getting my point. So for this, velocity is again equal to displacement upon time. Okay, so we can calculate very instantaneous velocity in this case. Suppose if this small displacement is ds and this very small time is dt, so we can write velocity v is equal to ds by dt. Okay, and this one is defined as the instantaneous velocity, because velocity is changing with respect to time. Okay, because these displacement in different intervals are very different. So if this is dt very small, then there is small change ds, so we can write velocity is equal to ds by dt, and this is known as instantaneous velocity. It means it gives velocity at any particular instant because it is variable in this case. It means velocity is variable. It means velocity is variable in non-uniform motion. Okay, here you can see a diagram which is plotted between velocity and time. Okay, so you can see the velocity at different times are different. So I hope you understand the difference between uniform and non-uniform motion. Okay, this one is the displacement time graph, and this one is velocity time graph. This graph can take different form. So plot different displacement time and velocity time graph for uniform and non-uniform motion. I hope you understand the concept between uniform and non-uniform motion. Okay, so in this case you can see the velocity v1 and this velocity v2. This v1 is equal to v2. It means at different times you can see, suppose this one is t1 and this one is t2. So at t1 and t2 the velocities are different in non-uniform motion, but it is same in case of uniform motion. So you can see here that v2 minus v1 is not zero, whereas in, you can see here, if the motion is uniform, then v2 minus v1 is zero. Okay, because these two are constant, because these two are same, because motion is uniform, so their velocity v1 at time 2 or t1 second and at t2 second are same. So it means v2 minus v1 are zero. From this you can understand the concept of acceleration. Rate of change of velocity is zero here. It means acceleration is zero. Acceleration is defined as rate of change of velocity. If v2 minus v1 is zero, it means acceleration is zero. If v2 minus v1 is not zero, then acceleration is not zero. So here acceleration is not zero. It means some acceleration is there, but in this acceleration is zero. Okay, so we will discuss acceleration in detail in next video. I hope you understand. Thank you.